Hello everyone, myself Shikha, your English teacher. Now we move on towards a grammatic session and start with parts of a speech which constitute all grammatic elements. Today we'll understand its first element, noun, in detail. This lecture is going to be a little elaborated but beneficial for the classes 9th onwards. That will clear your all basics as well as advanced concept of noun. So let's start. Now the definition of noun: a word that is the name of a person, animal, place, thing, quality, idea, and is typically used in a sentence as the subject or object of a verb or as an object of preposition. So noun are the verbs which can be used in a sentence at the place of subject, object of a verb, or object of preposition. Nouns are also called naming words. Now some examples of nouns like Mahatma Gandhi, boy, student, honesty, India, tree, crowd, beauty. So many examples can be there of naming words. Now have a look on the types of noun which we are going to discuss in this lecture. Common noun, proper noun, concrete noun, abstract noun, collective noun, compound noun, countable noun, uncountable noun, material noun, singular noun, plural noun, possessive noun, and some words acting as a noun. Those are pronouns and gerunds. Now on each type of the noun we are going to put equal emphasis with its definition as well as its examples, so that each and every type of the noun is going to be very much clear in your mind after taking out all your doubts. Now, very first type of noun is common noun. A common noun is a noun which describes a class of people, objects, etc., instead of denoting individual entities. In other words, common nouns are general names of places, items, objects, etc., and do not represent special entities. For example, let's go grab dinner. I really want a new pair of jeans. I really want to live in a big city. Now, common noun is the general noun. General noun means those places, those objects, those peoples which can be defined in a general way, not a specific, not particular individual, but in general manner. And if we see the examples, let's go to grab dinner. Now dinner is a common thing, it's a general thing, it is not a specify what is there in the dinner. Okay, so dinner is general for all. Now a pair of jeans, again, it's not any particular name is given to jeans. Jeans is a general outerwear for everyone. Now big city, again, the big city by name it is not clarified. Any of the big city can be this. So there are so many big cities, so again it will come in a general class. Now some more example of the common nouns. I want to make you clear through the simple pictorial example, so that the general category combined in the common noun can be very much clarified in your mind. Okay. So, some of the pictorial examples are ball, bat, bat, book, boy, bun, cake, cap, car, cat, cow, cup, dog, doll, fan, foot, girl, gun, hat, hand, jar, kite, man, pan, pet, pie, pig, pot, red and van. Now if you can see in all these pictorial examples, these are the general example, not specifically combined with any particular thing. Okay, means these are the things that are used by everyone, that is having or owning by everyone, or that is possessing on the earth. Now some example which are making difference between common and proper noun. In first list some common nouns are given, and in second list the name of those common nouns in the form of proper nouns are given. So first is writer, and the name of writer is Mark Twain. City, and the city is Chicago. Planet is Mars. River, that is a common noun, and river Thames is a proper noun. Restaurant and name of the restaurant is Kate's Delicatessen. And tea, the name of the tea is Earl Grey. Drink is a type of common noun and Coca-Cola will come in the proper noun category. Building is a common noun example and Burj Khalifa is an example of proper noun. And a website, you can say the vocabularypage.com. Again, this is a proper noun. Second noun is proper nouns are nouns that refers to specific people, places or things. Proper nouns like MP, Anshuman or White House are capitalized to show their distinction from common nouns such as a state, man or building. Now state is a general category, many of the state can be there. Man again is a general category of human beings and building. Building is again the category in which we can combine so many different buildings. But MP is a specific state. Anshuman is come for the specified individual and White House is a particular building. Now we have specified when you are giving any name, any identity or any speciality to the general category or common noun that it will come in the category of the common noun. Now here we are talking about not any other state but only MP. Now here we are talking about Anshuman and not besides any of other human being. Here we are denoting the building that is White House and not other building. So we have a specified and given name. So all these are the examples of the proper noun. Now some more example of the proper noun. Jesus, Taj Mahal, Loch Ness Monster, Jupiter, Australia, Plesiosaurus, Titanic, Bayoxy Tapestry, Santa Claus, the Bible, King Charles I. Now these all are the name of a specified person, specified place and specified animal. Okay, so this is the speciality for the particular thing, particular place. So it will all will come in proper nouns. Now here the combined list of common nouns and proper nouns has been given so that you can easily find the difference between the general and a specific category. So one by one we'll take the category. The first category is of student. Student is a general category. Annalisa, Elizabeth, Williams, these are the individual, particular individual specified with the name. So these will come in proper nouns. Another category is holidays, New Year's Day, Martin Luther, King Day, and in India, like we celebrate Independence Day, Republic Day. So these are the specified day. Holidays can be many, but Republic Day will be only one. Okay, so that will it will come in proper nouns. Newspapers, so many newspapers can be there in general category. The Daily Telegraph, the Wall Street Journal, Dainik Bhaskar, Rajasthan Patrika, they are specific newspapers with its name. So this will come in proper noun. Now city is a particular city like Tokyo, Austin, Boston, Delhi, Mumbai. These are the particular city by its specified with its name. Countries again is a general category. Many of the countries can be there, but there will be only one Japan, one Austria, one Norway, one India. So these are the specific category. States. States is general category. Many of the states, but New Jersey, California, UP, MP, Rajasthan, Maharashtra, these will come in the specific category and in the example of proper nouns. Again, banks, many of the banks can be there, not one particular bank is given. So bank will come in common noun and Corporation Bank, People's Bank of China, Punjab National Bank, State Bank of India, these are the specific bank. Okay, so it will come in proper noun category. Now hotels, so many hotels can be there, but Sheja Inn Hotel, Executive House, these are the specific hotel. We are particular talking about one specific hotel, so all these will come in proper noun. Restaurants can be there, many of the restaurants, but Party for Life of Pie, Mr. Bean's, these are the specific restaurants we are talking about. Organizations, so many organizations all over the world can be there, but United Nations, World Health Organization, this will come in a
proper noun category. Parks, many of the parks can be there, but the National Park, Shah Shams Park, this will come in specific category. Now, places, many of the places, but here in the proper noun, we are talking about Fifth Avenue, Fizzy Islands, MI Road, Nehru Bazaar, Bapu Bazaar. These are the specific places. Continents, many of the continents can be there in all over the world, but Africa, Australia, Asia, North America, we are talking about the particular continent by its name. So all these are example of the proper nouns. And the last category is oceans. So many oceans can be there. It will come in general or common noun category. And the caption sea, North Sea, Red Sea, these will come in proper noun category. So here I hope you understand to find the difference between the general and specific category through the common and proper noun. Now type number 3 of the noun is concrete. Nouns are the nouns that refers to the things that exist physically and can be touched, seen, smelt, felt or tasted. Here are some examples. Can I pet your dog? Please pass the salt. Your sweater is made of such soft wool. Now, concrete noun can be perceived by at least one of our five senses. Now, concrete means original. What is present before you? Okay, what is there in front of you that you can touch, that you can see, smell, feel or taste? So, no specific categories come for the concrete noun. Any of the thing that you can use or that you can feel or taste or smell through your five senses of your body, they all will come in concrete. Concrete nouns. So some of the examples like cup, cake, ball, chair, keys means any of the senses you have to use to listen to the music, you have to use hearing sense to feel something, you have to touch that thing, to take the taste of some edible thing, you have to use your tasting buds to see something, you have to use your eyes, and to smell any particular thing, you have to use your smell, sense of smell. So any of the thing, any of the category, any of the edible things or food items or any of the place, person, means any type of category can come in the concrete noun that is present before you, and you can feel that with your five or any of the five senses. As I told you earlier, all types of noun fall under the category of concrete noun, because concrete means original, and whatever the original, whatever we can see and touch, they will fall under the category of concrete noun. So almost all types of noun except abstract noun will fall under the category of concrete noun. Many types of noun are still left to be studied. We'll going to complete those nouns in detail as we move on, but right now I am just placing the example of each types of noun that fall under concrete noun. So here are some nouns. Like all the proper nouns will come under the category of concrete noun. All types of common noun, all types of collective and material noun, they all come under concrete noun. So let's see the example of proper nouns like Rajappa John, Mangalore, Delhi, Dianora, TV, Deepu, Guru, Shashikala. These all are the name of the definite place, definite person or definite thing. Now common nouns like student, teacher, river, chair, road, city. Again, these all examples are original example, concrete example. So they will fall under concrete noun. Some collective nouns like family, army, staff, crowd, flock. Again, these all examples are concrete original. So they all the collective noun will also come under concrete noun. Material like gold, silver, clay, wood, iron, and wool. All these materials that you can easily touch and see, so they all will fall under concrete noun. Now one noun is besides from the concrete noun, and that is abstract noun. Some of the example of abstract nouns like patience, childhood, priestship, darkness and chemistry. Now as the example is itself telling that all these examples are not original, they are invisible. You cannot see patience, you cannot touch childhood, you can just express them or feel them. So I hope you can now make the difference between the concrete nouns and the abstract nouns.
abstract nouns, ideas, qualities, or conditions like love, hate, power, and time, they all are the examples of abstract nouns. Now, examples are, all you need is love. There is so much hate for the new Star Wars trilogy. We must use this time wisely. In these sentences, the abstract nouns refers to concepts or feelings that cannot be understood concretely or touched physically. So, the abstract nouns means something invisible, you can see, okay? You can just feel that thing, you cannot see that thing, you cannot touch that thing, or that is not present before you concretely in the original manner. Now, love is a thing you cannot see, you cannot touch that thing, but you can feel. Hate again is a type of quality that you can feel only, you cannot touch or see it. Now, time is again the condition, the time, you cannot touch the time, you cannot see the time, you can just feel the time passing on. So these are the invisible means abstract nouns are the nouns. They are basically the form of ideas, the form of qualities, and the form of condition. Now, here are some different types of abstract noun examples has been given according to category. Now, first of the category is feelings. The examples of the feelings has been anxiety, fear, and pleasure. These are the feelings that you can feel. Now, states are called condition. Now, what can be the condition? Like freedom, chaos, misery. These are the condition. Again, you cannot see and touch. Again, the category is emotions. Which type of emotions can be there, like anger, shock, and sorrow? These are invisible things. You can just feel or express. Now, again, the next category is called qualities. Now, which type of qualities you are having? These are the positive senses, okay? So, courage, honesty, patience, and many more. So, these are the qualities that you can show. Concept is called charity, comfort, and deceit. These are the different examples of the category concept. And another category is moments. Moments can be like birthday, marriage, death. Again, you cannot see or touch birthday or marriage. You can just go and enjoy or can feel. So all these things, all invisible things will come in abstract noun.
Now, let me make you clear the abstract noun with the use of sentences. An abstract noun is a word which names something that you cannot see, hear, touch, smell, or taste. Now, let's see some sentences. We have to get at the truth of the matter. So, in this sentence, abstract noun is shown by the word truth. Next is, Mary isn't the type of a person who gossips. Now, gossips is something that you cannot see or touch. So, gossips will come under the category of abstract noun. Next is, people lost faith in books. Now, faith is something that you can feel, not see and touch. So, faith will be an abstract noun. Next is, she will defeat them. Now, defeat again is an invisible thing, not an original thing. So, it will fall under abstract noun. I was delighted at the news of her success. Now, success that you can feel, that you can express, but not seen. Success is not a person or a thing that you can see or touch or you can hear. So, this will come under abstract noun. They laughed at my idea. Here, idea is an abstract noun. Alex had a fear that he would fall down. Now, fear is a kind of example of abstract noun. She tried to restrain her anger. Again, anger is an example of abstract noun. Don't underestimate your own strength. Now, strength is something that you cannot touch or smell. So, it will come under abstract noun. And the last one is, Samuel has a good side and an evil side. Now, evil and good, something that you cannot see, touch or smell or taste. So, they will come under the category of abstract noun.
Next type is collective nouns, are nouns that refer to a group of something in particular. Often collective nouns are used to refer to a group of animals, people, things, or objects. Some of the examples, look at that gaggle of geese. There used to be a herd of wild buffaloes on the prairie. A crowd of kids is in the pool today. The team did a great job in the competition. Now, as the name suggests, you can understand that collective means collection, means there is more than one thing. They are collected at one place. That's why we are addressing them a collective noun. So here you can see more than one people, things or object that are collected at one place, but this collection is given a particular name to different category, to different people, to different animals and different things. So here some more examples according to the category. So first category is of people: a band of man, a cast of actors, a stake of librarians, a sentence of judges, a galaxy of beauties, a bevy of girls, a choir of singers, and a hack of smokers. Now, different type of peoples is given in one category, that is people, but we cannot use a band of actors, we cannot use a cast of librarians, we cannot use a sentence of beauties. There is a particular name for the group of these peoples that will come in the people category. We can use the group of the man is there, we will use a band of man. If the group of actor will be there, we will use cast. Okay, librarians group, many of the librarians are sitting together, we are going to use a stake of librarians. So according to this, the collection for different people, then we are going to have the different name of that collection. Now another category is animal category: a colony of girls, a brood of hens, a flight of birds, a flock of turkeys, a group of guinea pigs, a litter of cubs, a kennel of dogs, and a sloth of bears. Now see, all these are animals. All these are animals we can find in the groups, but the name of those groups, the name of those collection where the particular animal is collected is given different name. Like we cannot write colony of hens, we have to write colony of girls. So these are the different categorized collective nouns according to the particular group of animals. And the last category is things: a batch of cakes, a bottle of milk, a bowl of rice, a box of cereal, a can of soda, a carton of milk, and a cup of tea. Now you cannot write a cup of rice, no. A bowl of rice will be there and a cup of tea will be there. So particular collective noun for the particular things.
Some more examples of collective noun in mixed categories: a quiver of arrows, a range of mountains, a ream of paper, a reel of film, a set of clubs, a sheaf of grain, a shower of rain, a stack of wood, a string of pearls, a bed of notes, a chest of drawers, a cluster of coconuts, and a cloud of dust. A horde of savages, a bale of cotton, a basket of fruit, a batch of bread, a galaxy of stars, a group of islands, a fleet of ships, a forest of trees, a hail of bullets, a hand of bananas, a harvest of wheat, a heap of rubbish, and a hedge of bushes. A body of man and a bunch of crocs, a caravan of gypsies, a choir of singers, a class of students, a company of actors, a gaggle of geese, a haul of fish, a herd of cattle, a hive of bees, a gang of prisoners, a battery of guns, and a block of flats. So these collective nouns you need to be learned because they are preset. Next are compound nouns, contain two or more words that join together to make a single noun. Compound nouns can be two words written as one, such as softball and toothpaste. Words that are hyphenated or there is a hyphen in between of them, such as six pack and son-in-law, or separated word in the open form like post office and upper class, that go together by meaning. Now compound means more than two, but they are making a single noun. There are two separate words and both the words have their different identity. They are complete word in itself, but again by combination they are again making a third noun. So that category will come in compound noun. So some of the examples of the compound noun, like break,
fast. When we join break and fast, that will become in break fast. Break is another complete word, fast is another complete word, but when we are joining break fast, again a new word has come, break fast. Okay, so some of the compound nouns is a noun which is made up of the two or more words that we can see: haircut, ice cream, rainforest, football, aircraft, bathroom, self-esteem, eggplant, software, armchair, fireman. Now here you can see these all are the words that contains two words in itself and again making third noun. First have a look at how to make a compound nouns. We can add noun plus noun, we can add adjective plus noun, but there are other combination examples as well, like how to make a compound noun by joining noun and noun, like bus stop. Now bus is a noun and stop another again is a noun. So is this the bus stop for the Angel Street? Now this is the use of the sentence. So in this sentence the compound noun is bus stop. Football. Do you like football, Mr. George? Now here see, foot is a type of noun, ball again is a type of noun. So after joining noun and noun, we make another compound noun that is called football. Now come to the adjective and noun. Blackboard. Now see the sentence, Samuel, please clean the blackboard. Now here you can see black is an adjective and board is a noun. So by joining black and board, a new compound noun has been created, that is blackboard. Next is software. Can you install this important software on my PC? Now in this sentence the compound noun is software, in which soft is a type of adjective and where is a type of noun. So after joining software, a new compound noun has been created, that is software. Now we are creating another compound noun by adding verb and noun. Now here see, breakfast. They always eat breakfast at 9 a.m. Now here break is a type of verb and fast is a type of noun. So by joining these, a new compound noun has been created, that is breakfast. Swimming pool. What a beautiful swimming pool. Now in this sentence the compound noun is swimming pool. Swimming is a kind of verb and pool is a kind of noun. By adding it we have made a new compound noun, that is swimming pool. Now other forms can be created, like we can place the noun first and verb later on, we can place the verb plus preposition, and we also can see the preposition plus noun. So like these we can take out some word and after joining two words a new word will be created, that is called compound noun. But remember, the new word whatever has been created, that should be meaningful. Now let me make you clear the abstract noun with the use of sentences. An abstract noun is a word which names something that you cannot see, hear, touch, smell or taste. Now let's see some sentences. We have to get at the truth of the matter. So in this sentence, abstract noun is shown by the word truth. Next is, Mary isn't the type of a person who gossips. Now gossips is something that you cannot see or touch. So gossips will come under the category of abstract noun. Next is, people lost faith in books. Now faith is something that you can feel, not see and touch. So faith will be an abstract noun. Next is, she will defeat them. Now defeat again is an invisible thing, not an original thing. So it will fall under abstract noun. I was delighted at the news of her success. Now success that you can feel, that you can express but not seen. Success is not a person or a thing that you can see or touch. Came to next type of nouns. Countable, that can occur in both single and plural forms and can be modified by the numbers and can be co-occur with the quantifying determiners such as many, most, more and several, etc. For example, the noun bike is a countable noun. There is a bike in that garage. In this example, the word bike is singular because it refers to one bike that is sitting in a particular garage. However, bike can also occur in the plural form, like there are six bikes in that garage. In this example, the plural noun bikes refers to more than one bike because it is being modified by the number six. In addition, countable noun can be used with the determiners like severals rather than a number. In that garage, there are several bikes. Now, countable, as the name suggests, the things, the nouns that you can count. So only those categories will come that you can count here, okay? Means then in the numbers, like 1, 2, 3 and endless, till endless, that you can count in numbers. Here the examples of bike has been given. Bike can be one also, and many of the bikes can be also, and you can count the bikes, fine. Like in garage there is one bike, there is in the garage there are six bikes or seven bikes, or if there are many bikes you cannot count, then you are going to use the determiners like there are many bikes in the garage, there are several bikes in the garage. So we can also use the quantifying determiners. Quantifying is called which denotes the quantity, which denotes the number, okay? So we can also use the words like many, most, more, several, okay? These also can be used with the countable nouns. Some more example of countable nouns. Now, examples in the category of countable nouns, we are dividing the things according to their number. The thing can be one also, and that countable thing can be in numbers also. So for the one thing, for the single thing, the basic word will come up for that thing, and for if the thing is increased in number, then the plural form of that word will be coming. Like here there is a and there is not a, means in the negative sense or in the positive sense, whatever is there, like according to the sentence, you are going to use a with the singular, and there are some, few, lots of nouns like any or many. These are denoting the increased number of the things, okay? So according to the basic word, we are going to change the plural form in of that word and denoting it as a countable noun. So here are some basic word has been given, and according to how we are going to make the plural form of that particular word, I'm going to tell you. So some of the words which are which are having the letters like X, S, double S, S, E, S, H, C, H, Z, E, G, E, like that. At the end of words, they all are going to change in ES. Like box, boxes, bus, buses, glass, glasses, house, houses, dish, dishes, sandwich, sandwiches, size, sizes, orange, oranges, tomato, tomatoes. Now you can see the ending of these words, and you can see the changed plural form of these words that shows the countable nouns. Now again, the basic words which are not having any particular thing last as the previous one, they are just changed simple by adding S. Like apple, apples, photo, photos, month, months, VIP, VIPs, okay? Only S will be there, and that will show the number of the increased category of that particular noun. Now, vowel category, when we are having Y at the end of the word, like toy, that will come in toys, key, keys, day, days, monkey and monkeys. These all are the nouns, these all are the examples that you can count. That's why they have come in the countable noun category. Again, next category is the consonant plus Y, when we are having Y at the last, like, and they will change in the IES. And these are some examples are baby, babies, cherry, cherries, family, families. Now you can see the plural form has been changed, the Y has been changed in IES, but some of the nouns. And next category that will change in VES and having the last letters FE, like wife, wives, life, lives, loaf, loaves, wolf, wolves. These all are the again countable nouns and change in the plural form according to the last word category. Now irregular plural nouns, some of the irregular that are going to be changed by making the changes in between of the letters, like man, M-A-N, and that will change in the plural form by M-E-N. Same as woman, women, child, children, foot, feet, tooth, teeth, goose, geese, mouse, mice, person, people.
So these all the things, all the nouns have been given in the example. They all can be counted, they all can be increased in numbers. That's why they have come in the category of countable noun. Next are uncountable nouns. On the other hand, some of the nouns are not countable. You will see them referred to as uncountable, non-countable or mass nouns. For example, the word clutter is an uncountable noun. Example, the garage is full of clutter. This sentence makes grammatical sense. However, the following example does not. The garage is full of clutters. Now, uncountable noun usually cannot take plural form. Therefore, clutters is not grammatically correct. Liquids and powders are among the items that are considered mass nouns, such as milk, rice, wood, sand, water and flour. Other nouns, other more abstract examples that cannot be counted would be air, freedom or intelligence. So uncountable, you can imagine, means uncountable, that cannot be count, means that cannot in a form of thing that you can count, like in numbers 1, 2, 3, you cannot count. So all those things will come in uncountable noun. Uncountable noun, generally they cannot take the plural form. Plural form means if they cannot be counted, if they cannot increased in numbers, we cannot make the plural form of those nouns. Okay, so most of the time some liquids and powder, the things, those are in liquid form or in powder form. You cannot count the liquid form and the powder form things. Okay, like milk and rice, you cannot count milk, you cannot count rice. Okay, so all these things will come in uncountable noun. Now, like abstract nouns, we have gone through the abstract noun. Remember, abstract nouns mean the invisible nouns. You cannot see or touch, you can just feel. So some of the example of the abstract nouns do also come in uncountable noun, like air, freedom or intelligence. All the type of abstract nouns, you cannot count them, you can just feel them. So all these categories will come in uncountable nouns. Now here are some examples of uncountable noun. Uncountable does not include any of the numbers. So we cannot use the determinants like many, several, that we can use with the countable. But we can use like some, little, lots of, any and much. So some of the categories of the uncountable noun has been given. I'm going to recite for you. First category is liquid and creamy substances like juice, water, milk, alcohol, coffee, tea, lemonade, wine, yogurt, sauce, honey, jam, soup, ketchup, oil, ice cream, butter, paste, cream, rain, snow. These all are the liquid or creamy category that cannot be counted. Next category is of materials: wood, glass, plastic, stone, silver, metal, cloth, wool, paper, gold, ice and cotton. Again, this cannot be, any of the category cannot be counted. Next is substances smaller than a bean. Those are rice, flour, sugar, soil, salt, pepper, powder, scent, grass, chalk, wheat, corn. These are little, means these are more smaller than a bean. So we cannot count it. Okay, so all these will come in uncountable noun. Next category is of gases: air, smoke, steam, oxygen, CO2 and fog. And a smoke, these all category will come in guesses, and guesses also cannot be count. Next category is of abstract: love, music, art, noise, help, work, homework, housework, literature, weather, knowledge and power. Now all these you cannot see, you cannot touch, as well as you cannot count. Next category is what you out of the major, that you cannot measure. Those are bread, chocolate, cheese, pizza, cake, pasta, meat, chicken, salad, popcorn, pastry, spaghetti. Now these are the things that you cannot measure. Okay, a packet of bread, generally we know the packet of bread, but if the slices of bread, then you have to use like two slices of bread, three slices of bread. Like this you have to use, but here in the combination, in the combined form, bread will come in the category of uncountable noun because it cannot be measured, because bread can be of any shape of any or any size. Okay, so we will count, we will include it in the uncountable noun. And chocolates also, chocolates can also be in any shape, in any size. So for the complete whole chocolate will come in the category that cannot be measured, and that will come in the uncountable noun. So all these edible items are there. If you have the confusion that you can count, but you have to use another noun for this, another type of adjective to denote, like bread. You cannot say two bread. No, two bread means what is the meaning of two bread? Two packets of bread or two slice of bread? Now here you can see the difference. So bread will come in the category that cannot be measured. If you are talking about slice of bread, then you have to put two slice of bread. If you are putting two packets of bread, then you have to put two packets of bread, two packets of pizzas, two packets of chocolates. Okay, so as a whole, these all edible items will come in uncountable noun. Fine. Now the last category is others, that like information, money, advice, news, luggage, traffic, accommodation, furniture, cash and time. These also we cannot see, we cannot touch, and even we cannot count. So all these example will come in the uncountable nouns. I hope you understand these uncountable nouns, how to divide the countable and uncountable, and how to recognize them. For your better understanding and delightful visibility, I have divided the countable and uncountable nouns in the pictorial form of the edible items so that you can make the difference better between the countable and uncountables. First I am going to read about the countables. Bun, sandwich, apple, orange, burger, fries, eggs, salad, vegetable, cookies, potatoes, tomatoes, carrots, hot dogs, candies, olives, peanuts, pancakes, watermelon, pea, grapes and cherries. These all the things you can count. Like in salad, so many vegetables are there. If you have the confusion in the salad, salads are made of vegetables. Means there is not a particular ingredients or particular number of categories are there that you are going to add only four vegetable or five. Many of the vegetables, like you can say just cut two bananas, two cucumbers, one of the beetroot, like that. So it means salad you can count. You can count according to the vegetable or according to the ingredients that have been put in the salad. So it will come in countable category. Now came on to the uncountable categories: bread, fruits, juice, meat, rice, cereals, jam, milk, coffee, sugar, flour, juice, salt, soup, tea, cottage cheese, pasta, honey, water, cheese, butter, seafood and mustard. These all will come in uncountable nouns. Now again, fruit, generally whenever you go outside, fruit, you always measure the fruit, like 1 kg banana, okay, 5 kg apple, means half kg of grapes, like this. Means these are the measurable things. So whatever the things are, edible things are there that you can measure, that will come in uncountable noun. And the edible things what are in the form of flour and liquid, they always come in uncountable noun. So I hope you now understand the difference between countable and uncountable nouns. Okay,
so this is going to be the first part of the types of noun. Nearby half of the nouns I have covered in this lecture, and the remaining types of the noun I am going to cover in part 2. So that's it for now. We'll meet again.